Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in ac lacrima.
Good morning, everyone, on this Friday of the fifth week of Lent. I was hoping that March, which began like a lion, was going to leave like a lamb. It didn't get the notice. It's just lovely weather out there today. And so certainly for those of you who are staying at home because of the weather, please be safe. For those of you who are here at church, please be careful when you're skiing on those sidewalks, that lovely combination of snow and ice, and with the wind, is polishing the surfaces accordingly. I want to invite people to listen to the psalm response today. It comes from the heart, but it has for us a way forward in the midst of human difficulty. And I'm going to talk about that in the homily. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, we call to mind our sins, asking the Lord for pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who in this season give your church the grace to imitate devoutly the Blessed Virgin Mary in contemplating the Passion of Christ, grant, we pray, through her intercession, that we may cling more firmly each day to your only begotten Son, and come at last to the fullness of his grace, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble They will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe the mind and the heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them, for to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. I love you, O Lord, my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Praised be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. The breakers of death surged round about me. The destroying floods overwhelmed me. The cords of the netherworld enmeshed me. The snares of death overtook me. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. In my distress, I called upon the Lord and cried out to my God. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
Have the words of everlasting life. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. The Jews picked up rocks to stone Jesus. Jesus answered them, I've shown you many good works from my Father. For which of these are you trying to stone me? The Jews answered him, we're not stoning you for a good work, but for blasphemy. You, a man, are making yourself God. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law? I said, you are gods. If he calls them gods to whom the word of God came and scripture cannot be set aside, can you say that the one whom the Father has consecrated and sent into the world blasphemes because I said, I am the Son of God? If I do not perform my Father's works, do not believe me. But if I perform them, even if you do not believe me, believe the works, so that you may realize and understand that the Father is in me, and I am in the Father. Then they tried again to arrest him, but he escaped from their power. He went back across the Jordan to the place where John first baptized, and there he remained. Many came to him and said, John performed no sign. But everything John said about this man was true, and many there began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. It's taken from Psalm 18, and it's verses 2 through 7, and they're beautiful because they raise up two very critical elements that we hold fast to as disciples of Jesus. In the first, this is a very real, from-the-heart cry. that the person who is speaking these words is speaking from suffering, difficulty, distress, and the imagery is very crystal clear. The breakers of death surged round about me. The destroying floods overwhelmed me. The cords of the netherworld enmeshed me. The snares of death overtook me. This is somebody in a world of hurt. This is somebody who's dealing with it up against the wall, doesn't know where to turn. This is pain. This is suffering. This is confusion, loss. This is hard. And we need to hold that up because we never want to sugarcoat when life is hard, when life throws curveballs our way and the difficulties are overwhelming. Lord knows we never just want to say, oh, it'll be okay and go on our way. We want to really be able to acknowledge, where's the pain? Where's the struggle? Where's the difficulty? Name it. And the psalm does that. It gets right to the heart of the stresses and struggles. But it doesn't stay there. See, there's a way forward. I love you, O Lord, my strength, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. That we, recognizing that life is hard and there are difficulties and challenges and struggles, look to the one who triumphed over all of it. That we call upon the Lord. And the Lord hears us. The Lord understands us. And the Lord responds. We're about to embark into the great mysteries of Holy Week. We will walk with Jesus as he carries his cross to Calvary. And then all of next week, we will slowly make our way from Holy Thursday with the Mass of the Lord's Supper and Good Friday, where again we will stand before the cross of Christ. We will wait in vigil on Easter Saturday and rejoice that the tomb is open and he's alive. The victory of God's grace through Jesus gives us the courage and conviction to make this cry in our need, that in our distress, we know that there is one who is the victor, the Savior, the Messiah who came into this world to break these bonds that chain us. So today, we bring two focuses to this, two points. Where's our distress? Folks, what's on our plate? What are we dealing with at this moment, right here, right now? Name it. Not out of fear, not out of worry. Name it. Just say, okay, Lord, this is what I got. This is where I'm at. And I call upon you, Lord, to give me the strength to put one foot in front of the other. I call upon you, Lord, to clear my mind so I see the path I need to take. Lord, I'm asking you to help me discern how I proceed through the challenge, the darkness, the difficulty. And Lord, give me the strength to make it happen. Lord, help me to carry my cross so that, like you, I will one day be victorious as well. This is at the heart of why we follow Jesus. He knows us, he loves us, and he died for us, so that we will be given the strength we need to face our difficulty and distress without fear, but rather with faith. God bless you all. We pray this day for Pope Francis, for our bishops, that they will lead and guide us with wisdom, especially in dark and challenging times. We pray to the Lord. This weather continues to disrupt the lives of many, folks who are plowing and salting, the people who are, you know, trying to deal with safety on the roads. We pray for all of those affected by inclement weather, but in a special way by those who are without homes, for those on the margin, that through our efforts we can alleviate their suffering and also work together to keep people safe. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of those who are in service sectors of our culture and society, for the people who do little things that have great impact, for people who care for us, for the people who continue to support us. We pray for all of us who work in many different ways in our culture, that through our efforts, We draw closer as a common family. We pray to the Lord. We pray for a blessed Holy Week, in a special way for those who've been away from the church. We pray that there will be a flowering of faith among those who are lost, confused, searching, or bitter, that they will see in us a sign of God's light shining through. We pray to the Lord. For the intention of this Mass, Sherry Hoffman, we pray to the Lord. For all of you at home, for the prayers you offer in the comment line, and for all of us, for the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord. Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord. O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, and choose from our homes those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons. Obtain for us many more. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Grant, O merciful God, that we may be worthy to serve ever fittingly at your altars, and there to be saved by constant participation. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exultation we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you.
a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. May the unfailing protection of the sacrifice we have received never leave us, O Lord, and may it always drive far from us all that would do us harm. Through Christ our Lord. I have some announcements. Tonight we've got dinner out at St. Anthony's, the second to last fish fry of the season of Lent that they have tonight, and then next week on Good Friday they will serve their final dinner for the season. Holy Week is a powerful opportunity, and I invite all of us to take part. I know that for some, maybe still watching online, this is an incredible opportunity to come to Mass, to join as we celebrate with Palm Sunday, the reading of the Passion. Perhaps a Holy Thursday, Good Friday service to draw together in faith, and certainly to come at Easter. The Lord calls us into these sacraments, invites us to receive Him. Certainly, we continue to live stream. Days like today are a good reason why. But we want to invite people to come together. Lastly, I want to say a word for those of you who watch online on Fridays. I was down in Cumberland yesterday, and I had some folks say, "Father, where's Bernie? How's Bernie doing?" And so I just wanted people to know online that Bernie had moved out of the area to be closer to his kids down in the cities. And so, Bernie, if you're watching today, just know people are still asking about you, and they miss your reading of the scriptures on Fridays at daily Mass. But I did want people just to know he's, to my knowledge, doing great, but has moved out of the area. For those of you looking for a podcast, you can find me at studypraserve.com, or my podcast is entitled Catholic Inspiration. Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Have a great day.